the thyroid gland, what's it going to do when you add a Roxane? It's going to say, I can go completely and utterly to sleep. Whereas if you can give some herbs even, or some correct homeopaths to strengthen the being, the thyroid, it'll start to work again. But if you suppress it and give the Roxane, that's the end of it. This was a case of a dog that was dying of immune-mediated hemolytic anemia. It came on quite suddenly, and I gave it a blood transfusion, and it lasted only a couple of days and was chewed up. So I sent it to the specialist centre. I have a specialist centre near me, and Natalie, the lady there, said that she took some blood out, and she said it was clotting on the slide in front of her. She said, I've never seen such a severe case. She said, just fill it full of cortisone. That's only treatment. And she sent it back to me. And I said to the owners, look, you know, this is a disease that has to be suppressed. The dog's going to die. And they said, no, you treat it. See how you go. So I kept the dog with me. I had it on a drip because I'd given one blood transfusion and it was sort of managing. It was still alive, you know, and I was giving it some fluid, but blood's pretty hard to get a hold of. And I didn't want to give another transfusion without, you know, in case of cross-reaction, you know, the problems you have. So in any case, I had it with me and I had it in a cage. I was treating it with a remedy called phosphorus, which is one of our main bleeding type remedies that we use where things aren't clotting and bleeding out. And it was doing okay, but phosphorus, as I mentioned before, phosphorus dogs are the most open-hearted. They are filled with joie de vivre or whatever the French thing. They are filled with life, and they are open-hearted and lovely, and everyone's friend. And I had it in the cage one day, and I went to move something on its drip, and it went whack at my hand. I thought, holy shit, you're not a phosphorus dog. And I thought, what the hell was that? You know, the dog had been living with me for 3 days and I hadn't seen that. And it was at that point I thought, I need to change. I need to change to something that suddenly attacks. And I was treated with a snake remedy and it got better. And the snake remedy I used was actually Crotalus horridus, or rattlesnake. And that was a cure. That dog, actually, after the Crotalus horridus, it got better. And like 100% better, and it was well for probably 5 years. And then the people came back to me, as owned by an old lady, and she came in, she said, look at me, I've just been at the hospital. And she had huge bites all over her arm with stitches in it. And I said, what's happened? She said, that dog has attacked me. And I said, what did you do? What happened? She said, I was just walking through the lounge here at night and went near it, and it's flown at me and attacked me. I had to go to the hospital. And the doctor said, I have to put the dog down. And I said, oh, okay, you know, I said, I know what to treat the dog with. I know what fixes its blood, I know how to fix its head. So I got that remedy in a 10M, which is like mental strength. And I gave it that. I said, just stay away for 2 days, and you'll find everything will be back to normal. And I gave it 10M, and it just became like a lamb again. It took the snake out of it, you know, and it was fine. But, so, weakness to emotional stresses like grief, especially if they've been rehomed. Animals feeding after being rehomed. This is a thing which I've come to understand as the years go by, that a lot of the time feeding, and I treat a lot of dogs with fits using remedies and cure them, a lot of them, not all of them, and a lot of them will start after a grief. And we get animals and think, I'll give it to the neighbours up there, or I'll give it to a new home, thinking that it's just like a, I don't know, a shuttle of some sort. And if you did that with your kids, they'd suffer grief. And we know that if you give your kids away, they'd lock you in jail for it, you know. But dogs, we don't think there's an issue. Oh, it's all right, I'll just give it to the neighbour, I'm leaving the town. And a lot of these, especially if it's done in a particular way of giving it away and then the dog has fits, will be cured by using a homeopathic remedy called Ignatia, which is made from St. Ignatius Bean. It's one of our main grief remedies, but it's for grief of a particular type. And grief comes in lots of forms. You know, around someone's coffin, you'll have one person who's in genuine deep grief, you'll have another one who won't cry, you'll have another one who's in shock and panic, you'll have another one who's angry at the person, why did you not leave me the money? Another one who's thinking, you know, why have you left me alone, I'm abandoned, you know. And we think grief is grief, but it's not. No symptom is just one thing. If I said to everyone, go and set that shower how you like it, everyone sets it different, you know, and this is why with homeopathics we have to be so accurate. But most of the fitting ones who go into a shock type grief after and get fitting within a few days of being rehomed, Ignatia fixes it and they never fit again. And then you could probably give them away and I wouldn't be so bothered. This dog was treated with, it had a seasonal allergy thing on its back, and it was treated with a remedy called graphites, or, you know, made from graphite, like, you know, graphite pencil. It's a remedy that I often use with itches in dogs that are a little bit fat and sluggish and lazy, and often the skin will have bits of moisture on it. It's just, you can see the vitality and shine on the coat too afterwards. Some may be accident prone, and if they improve in general, even this tendency can be repaired. This is bizarre. I went to a lecture once of a guy who was a doctor at Mount Isa Mines, and he said, I'll tell you, I've watched this for years, and if a rock's going to fall off a cliff, it'll always hit the same guy. He said, I don't know why, but I've seen it happen. And this is the thing, that sometimes people will have an animal, and it'll get run over, and then it'll get slammed in the door, and then it'll trip and tear its nail, and then it'll get in a fight and get attacked. And, you know, this accident prone is not a myth. It's actually a type of energy. What a dog may run that system. I might use a remedy, a simple one of the crash remedies like Arnica, which you've probably heard of, and there's a whole family of what homeopaths call the crash remedies, the compositae, and Arnica is one of those. And sometimes you might give Arnica or Veliceperinus or one of those crash remedies for a dog that's had an injury just for the bruise, and then not only will they improve in every way in their life, but they will no longer crash. And I think, what has gone on there? Why aren't they crashing now when they've crashed every 3 months? And maybe they're more aware, maybe they see stuff. I don't know what it is, but it's even that weird thing. Witch doctrine, you know, it's weird. Others can be attacked and bullied. This is the thing, is that often I find, this is another thing. Sometimes people come in, they've got five dogs, one is absolutely covered in fleas, and the other four have got one or two. And it makes you realise that even parasites, there's an attractor and there's the defender, whatever they, you know, the attacker and the defender. And you have to have that witness for those parasites to attack you. And in homeopathy, we'll often use a similar type of remedy for fleas or lice as for rape or injuries or being attacked by other dogs. It's the same type of energy. And people will sometimes come into me and they're putting an endless stuff, pile of flea stuff on, you know, it might be front bombing and bombing their house and double doses of Sentinel and everything, and they're still fleas. And sometimes if I give them one of those remedies, they come back and say, oh, that front bomb's starting to work now. Got some help from the energy.